Hi, welcome back. Today I just thought we'd paint a nice little painting that I think you're really gonna enjoy. Now let's see what we got up here. We got a pre-stretched 18 by 24 inch canvas, and I've just coated the whole thing with a very thin layer of the liquid white. And what the liquid white is gonna do is gonna make it very easy to paint and allow us to really blend and work the colors together. So, let's get started. I'm gonna take a little bit of the phthalo blue. We're gonna come up here into the sky. I'm gonna start with a lot of little X strokes. Just a little crisscross. Strokes, and as you can see, the liquid white is just blending in really nicely with this blue. We're trying to focus on making the darker areas on the top corners and top part of the painting, and making much lighter strokes as we go down, making them blending into a nice, beautiful horizon. And anyone can use this technique. It's very easy, even if you've never painted before. Just let your wrist play on the canvas. This is your world. You can do whatever you want. If you wanted to have a green sky, you could do that. There's nobody stopping you. Now we're gonna clean the brush. I have right here just a little odorless paint thinner. And here comes the fun part. Yep. So my favorite part of this whole thing is and to clean the brush. Alright, let's come back up here. Alright, so now we're gonna go in a little bit of titanium white. Let's go back up here, and we're just gonna start creating the indications of some happy little clouds up here in the sky. I just love clouds. They're so free. They're one of the easiest things to paint. All you gotta do is look outside on a beautiful sunny day and really study the clouds. See what they're made of. And you'll notice how they're always changing and floating so peacefully through the sky. And vary the shape of your clouds. Not all clouds look the same. They're all different. Some are small, some are big. You can even give each cloud a name. And put them up here, a little bit higher up in the sky. Make them a little bit faded. Sort of drifting off to the side, off the edge of the painting. Now, think I want a big, beautiful mountain. You guys know me, I love my big mountains. So, let's take a little bit of the midnight black, a little bit of the alizarin crimson. And then I think a little bit the Van Dyke brown. Just mix that up. Maybe a little bit more of the crimson. A little bit more of the Van Dyke brown. You want to sort of make a nice marble. Don't want to overmix this. We go, and then spread your paint out. Take a tiny little bit, tiny little roll of paint on the edge of your knife, and let's come up here. Now, make a big decision. Where does your mountain live? Yep, right there. Just drag your knife across. Need to worry too much about what's going on the bottom. Just worry right now about the top of your mountain. think about the direction. Okay, there we go. Now, I'm gonna wipe the knife off on a paper towel here. Now we're gonna think about some beautiful snow caps. We're just gonna take, brush out the titanium white and take a small roll of paint, just the smallest little roll. Come back up here and then no pressure. No pressure at all. You want the paint to just sort of break up. But by no pressure. Lightest touch you can muster. Barely gracing the canvas. Beautiful. And these things are they're just gonna happen for you. The least bit of effort, you got these beautiful things going on. But no pressure, no pressure. Just the tiniest roll of paint on the tip of your knife. So easy to overdo. Alright, now I'm going to take a little bit of Prussian blue and some midnight black. Same thing, we're just going to go. Just going to go back up here and see if we can find some shade here. Dimension to your painting. Okay. big back here. It just goes straight into the background. Even dark areas near the bottom of our mountain. Alright, let's wipe off our knife here. I'm going to take that old dirty 2-inch brush. Just tap the base of our mountain. Really make this base fade into the bottom. Just like that. Giving some distance to this mountain. Liquid white. And you really don't have to do much work to make this fade into the background. Alright. Now let's take a little bit. Keep your brush dirty. Take a little bit. Prussian blue and mix it with the sap green. We're gonna go right here into the base of our mountain and just put some little things in there. Probably just some trees in the background, but we want them to be dark because they're far away. Things that are far away are going to appear darker than things that are close up. No, the opposite. Things that are far away are going to appear lighter. Things get darker as they get close. So that's why that sap green is going to make it a little bit lighter. Almost like there's a mist at the bottom of this mountain. Just a nice mix of that sap green and Prussian blue. Create the illusion of some trees in the distance. Clean the brush and this part. I'm gonna beat the devil out of it. Alright, let's go back up here and we're gonna take a little bit of the phthalo blue and just a touch the alizarin crimson. Give it a nice lavender color. Beautiful. Alright, so let's go down here. And I think, yeah, there's some water. This is a mountain, the base of a lake. So we're just gonna take our brush, start from the outside, and pull the color in. So start from the outside, and just pull the color into the center. And let that liquid white work for you. See how it just blends so effortlessly. We don't have to spend hours working on this. Just sort of happens for us. Do some cross strokes in the center. There we go. So we don't have to spend hours working on this. Just happens. It happens so easily. Are these outsides are darker than the inside. There we go. Okay. Now let's see here. You know me. I like a big old tree. Let's clean our brush. It's your bravery test. Where do we want this big old tree to live? And take a little bit of the Van Dyke brown. And we're gonna come up here. Here we go. Where's our big tree gonna live? I think right here. Yep, there he is. Can't go back now. There he is. I think he's a big old evergreen tree. There. If you're having trouble with this, remember that a thin paint sticks to a thick paint. So always keep a little bit of linseed oil by your side to just thin your paint out a little bit if you're having problems with the paint not sticking. Now I'm gonna take my fan brush, a little bit of the sap green, decide where our light is coming from, and just add the indications of some highlights on these branches. Could even take a little of the bright yellow, mix it with the sap green, and wow, would you look at that? The lights really shine in there. Really adds nice detail. That's what's gonna make it sell. Just these little extra things. Alright. Now let's see. Clean off our brush. Remember, you're going to want to get some odorless paint thinner. Use turpentine. Not many people in your house are going to like you. You're going to chase everyone out. Alright, so let's see. I think we're going to see some nice bushes right down here. Again, it's your world. You get to decide where these bushes live and how they live. Figure out what their names are, how long they've been here, everything. So your world. You get to decide all of it. That's the beauty of painting. No one can tell you what to do. Don't have your parents telling you to do this or that. All they can do is tell you to take the trash out. But when you're painting, they can't tell you what to paint. This is where you have total freedom and total control. You want purple bushes? You can have some purple bushes. Down here, I'm going to have these sort of overhanging our water. Little things going over into the water. Just like that. I'm going to take a little bit of this sap green and just put some highlights on these bushes. Really make them sparkle. There we go. Yeah. Just little things here and there. I'm gonna take a little bit of that Van Dyke brown and a little of the midnight black and just create a little bank on the edge of our river or lake or whatever it is. It can be anything. It can be a pond. Just somewhere for our tree to live. And you know what? We don't want our tree to be lonely. So let's throw a couple bushes. Someone to keep them company. Right. Now we can take our knife and just go in here and just make the indications of the little sticks and twigs and some little things going on. Go in here in our water. Create some ripples. People are gonna think you spent hours going in here, but they won't know. It's our little trick. There we go. Right, well, I think this is ready to be signed. Let's just take our little pencil brush, some linseed oil. Let's sign this sucker. Thanks for joining us today, and happy painting, and God bless.